Hello friends, very good morning, myself Bala. In this video, I'm going to create a Camarilla pivot level scanner in a charting and how to create a scan for a narrow range or a higher level, higher value, lower value, everything we are going to create like a scan. Within a fraction of a minute or a second, we can get the list of stocks using the scanner, help of this scanner. So here I am going to show you how we can create the scan. But in a charting, so we didn't get a the scan like Camarilla levels, so we have to create an indicator or a new indicator first, and then we are going to use that indicator as a value to find out the our screeners or our stock screen. So how we can create a L3 and H3, R3 and R4, like all the levels where we are going to create a scan first. Okay, so how we can create a scan in this video, we are going to discuss here. And yesterday we told about that how to create the code, and that we have discussed on that. Okay. So now we are going to, first of all, we have to understand the Camarilla levels. Let's check the Camarilla formula, and you see that the what is the formula for a resistance and support. Here you see that the resistance and support, so we have to multiply it by this value, so that will give you the resistance point, the close price plus high price minus low price multiplied by 1.1 divided by 2. So simply, which we are getting that value. So for example, if you are going to take a R4, so the close price plus high price minus low price multiplied by 1.1 divided by 2, that is what the formula. So let's calculate 1.1 divided by 2. So we got 1.1 divided by 2, we got a 0.55. So that is a simply we can directly multiply it by the 0.55 with that close plus I minus low. So that is, we got a R4. And if you are going to take a R3, so 1.1 divided by 4, it is 0.275. Or simply we can multiply it by 2, that we can get a R4. So the value where we are getting from that, the equation. Now we are going to create that kind of code. Now we will go for a R4. R3 and S4 and S3 creations. So how we can create that in a particular this video. So we'll do it now. So first we will create the lower level, that is S3. So how we can create the S3? So here, first of all, we want to take the close. Yes, we are taking a close, and close price, let's check it out. S3 close price minus I minus low, right? So the close price, where we are going to take the close price, current close, and we are going to take the minus value, and here we are going to do some calculation with the multiplication as well as a subtraction. So we will use the bracket value. Again, we are going to use the bracket value. Why? Because of two scenarios we are going to do. And the first thing which we are going to multiply it by the number, because we are going to create a S3. So 0.275, that is what the value we are going to create, and with the multiplied by this value into, so we are going to use again bracket here. What we are going to do, I minus go. So this is what the formula where we are going to use for a Camarilla support 3, right? This is the formula. So we are creating an indicator, the current close minus the number 275, the bracket value of current candle high minus current candle low. So this is what the formula for Camarilla S3 level. So we can first of all we copy it out. Yes, and just same like that, we have to change only the value for a S4 also, right? Now what we given Camarilla,
Gorilla support 3. Copy and paste it again. And this is the code we are going to use on our scanner. Now we are creating an indicator. So we are going to create a Gorilla support 3 now, and I have submitted. So now the code will be that indicator will be added on the screener, and again I am going to create a new screener. So simply I am going to paste it out the last which one we are created, and again we are going to change the value only 0.55. okay, that will give you what we are going to use, right? Yes, okay, 0.55, even yes, 0.55 or even 0.550, both are same, right? So we will save this as a Gorilla support 4. Okay, we have created two support indicators. Yes, it is also be created, and again we are going to create the resistance indicator, the same formula, but we have to little bit modification on that. So first we are opening a bracket value, and again bracket. Now I'm going to create here for a 0.275, that is what R3. Okay, 0.275 here again multiplied by, because we are going to multiply the bracket with open, and here high minus low, high value minus low value. So here we are going to add in this value, we'll add the close price. Yes, this is for our Gorilla resistance 3, because we are using the number 0.25. so we will copy that also, and we will create, save Gorilla resistance 3. Copy and paste it. It done. And again create a new one. Simply we paste it out, and we will change the value 0.85. And this is what our resistant 4. So now we created somewhere on Gorilla 4 levels, that is what S1, S3, S4 and R3, R4 we are created using the custom code creator, the custom indicators. So we created a custom indicator. Now I am going to charting. Now I can find the code which I have created. Okay, so what I am going to do, how I am going to make to find out that kind of filters. For example, now I'm going to find out or create a scan. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to take that Gorilla. So if you are directly checking, you are not getting that resistance on, and now the resistance 3, we are taking a Gorilla resistance 3 which is less than, that is what less than again H3, Gorilla resistance 3, that is what a resistance 3 or H3 or R3, both are all are same. So now we turn it. So here what we are going to take, and latest resistance is less than the 1 day ago resistance. So, and second one we are going to create and copy paste. Okay, Now, 1 day ago, support 3 is greater than. And latest resistance. Let's check what is the code we are. I hope I am doing right. Well, just can't. No stocks were there. Greater than. Let's find out. There you go. Stocks were fine. Resistance. First of all, we will find out the any stock which is present based on that. Agree. We'll go for a future segment. Let's do it. 1 day ago, Camarilla is 3. Latest. Let's find out. Yes, Bharat Forge, let's check it out. Okay, go resistance 3. Here it is less than previous 1 day ago. Yes, we have to change something. Here 1 day ago, there we attest. IGL. Yes, previous day's resistance is little higher and we are seeing the today's resistance is lower. Now we copy and paste it. Here we can take Camarilla support 3. Here we give a greater than. Got a Bandhan Bank today. Let's check it out, Bandhan Bank. Yes, we find the Bandhan Bank which is forming a inside day. So where we are, as per our coding, we are finding out the stocks which is giving you perfect inside setup. So using the scanner, we can take how the stock is creating a inside setup compared to previous day. So we can filter out here the future stocks, out any stocks. Didn't get that. Latest resistance is less than 1 day ago resistance. Yes, perfect. Latest resistance is day ago resistance, and here little bit higher. We got it. Tata Motors. Because we seen today Tata Motor for a sell opportunity, but still we are waiting for our trade opportunity or maybe a triggered and wait for that. If that stock is not coming, let's do that. There you go. Got to be pro. These are the stocks yesterday, I think. Pro. Here. Test. It is confusing, but we will find out. So Bandhan Bank BEL. So I think right now it is scanning, and we are doing the end of the day, so we will be getting clear levels for we can find out. I think BEL. Oops, use a false. Maybe the current yes. Day ago we are using 1 day ago. Just I will pause this video and I will make clear. Wait. Yeah, so this is the right one because we are using on the daily basis closing that level. We are creating the indicator. So 1 day ago Camarilla resistance is less than 2 days ago Camarilla resistance 3, and 1 day ago Camarilla support is greater than 2 days ago Camarilla support. So what it indicates, So we will find out based on that. So we will get the narrow or inside value Camarilla pivot points. And so a lot of stocks which you can get. So some we can filter out even the stock which is trading intraday. So the stock is good for intraday. For example, Idea. So we can ignore it. Like so we will find out. So if you check these all the stocks which forms around some 25 stocks which forms inside day. Let's say somewhere around any stocks, NMDC, like India Housing Finance also forming a inside A compared to previous S3, R3 and S3. Okay, and NMDC, let's check it out all the stocks, whether it is forming perfect or not. Yeah, this is also be perfect. And now you see the live market, we can, while checking that, we have some breakout opportunity on NMDC around 169.7 and with the stop loss of this one. The below stop loss we can make a R3 and other stocks like Power PFC, Power Finance Corporation and all the stocks we can scan within a minute or within a seconds we can filter out all the stock which forms a inside kind of day. So all the stock which is forming an inside day that and these stocks also given a breakout in opening itself. So in a opening candle itself it is gives a breakout, so there will be a less chances to make take a entry because it is given by 920 itself. So leave it. And now if you are again it is pulled back from the same level around 122.65, we may try to take that level with the stop loss of the same below R3. So I hope this may be, and I will save this scan as narrow Camarilla finder. So you can check it. Arrow or side Camarilla. Right. You can give us the 6% scans. Now you can find out the narrow Camarilla finder. So now we can easily scanners. Let's check it out. NARROW narrow Camarilla narrow side. So if it's such here, you will be getting that. So you can just use it and run the scan and you will be getting the stocks in a seconds. I hope this may be a useful video to you all. And using the Camarilla levels, how we can do the effective trading. So that will give you some better opportunity. Thank you for watching this video and thank you. Same indicator, so we can create a wider range. Like this is what a greater than, this is what a less than. Then now the total thing was changed and Vibro, Tata Consumer and Britannia. Let's see Vibro Limited. You see that the wide range. So if it is a wide range, so we can use sell at this point. That is a reversal trade. We can focus for that. This stock reversal trades and Tata Consume. Again, the reversal trade kind of pattern which is forming here. So we can easily filter out with the charting. So we can make use of this video. And thank you for watching.
PEL Dr. Reddy.
Thank you very much.